Now that we know what both numbers and strings are in Python, it's time to move on to list. List is a very common used data type because you can use it to store both numbers and strings and other data types as well. So you should view a list like a grocery list, where you can have a lot of items on a list, and these can be different items like carrots and potatoes and so on. Similar in Python, you can declare a list like this, and then you can simply fill it with items. So we say item 1, and then you comma separate the items, and then you say, for example, item 2, and then you can say integers. So now we have declared, I'll just delete this and this old code and assignment, so we can rename this my list. So now we have a list containing of 4 items. The first value is item 1, item 2, and then we have the numbers 2 and 3. If we want to view what's in our list and print it to the console, we can say print, and then reference to my list, and then we need to specify what element of the list we want to print. And our list start with the value of 0, meaning that this is position 0, this is position 1, 2, and 3. So if I want to print out item 1, I will simply say my list and then the position of 0. So if I print this, I will get item 1. If I say 2, I will get this value. And if I say, let's say 5, I will get an error because we don't have that many elements in our list. As you see here, the list index is out of range, meaning that I asked for a bigger number than was declared in my list. So lists are very useful when you are programming, because you can store a lot of items in them and then call them based on an index definition. So the next assignment will be write a list of 5 elements where 3 of the elements are strings. You can name them whatever you want, and the last 2 elements are integers. Then I want you to print, use the print operation, one of your strings, concatenated with one of your numbers. So you should be able to use this list like you did in the previous assignment, where you printed a string and concatenated with a number. But in this exercise, you will have to use your list to call the values. Pause the video and try to solve this exercise. So how did it go? A way we can do it is, I will just change these to a more meaningful value. So I will say this is my number, and then I want to print out this string and one of my numbers right here. So we will just be adding another value such that we live up to the elements right here, element 3. So I will say my list and then the first position, and then I can simply use the concatenation of plus and say my list, and then reference to an index where I have a number. So it will be 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4, because I want to have 3 printed out. So if I execute this, oh, and as you see, I just forgot what I taught you in a previous section. Hopefully you didn't. You still need to convert this to a string. So we will simply be using the string conversion, and then have the my list with an index of 4 within this, because this value will be the value of the position 4 in our list, meaning this value. So when you're calling it like this, Python is really getting the value of 3 in here and converting it to a string. So when we execute this, As you see, it now runs fine and they say this is my number and it is 3.